Sridharan resigned from the Kochi shipyard and later on engaged in a new project. This project was at the coastal regions on India's map, such as Maharashtra, Bombay, Goa, and Karnataka. This new project was called the Konkan Railway Project. The Indian Railways is divided into four regions: North, South, East, and West. And the Konkan Railway Project covers the coastal regions such as Maharashtra, Goa, Karnataka. E. Sridharan was involved and worked in this big project. These sites were located on the seas and coastal regions and needed the construction of many tunnels, bridges, etc. The total project covered 760 kilometers from Maharashtra to Karnataka and had over 150 bridges. E. Sridharan worked with full dedication. Many other people were also involved in this project. The project required to dig 93 tunnels along a length of 82 kilometers. With tireless diligence and efforts from E. Sridharan and the team involved in this project, the railway route got ready from Maharashtra to Karnataka, covering a total of 760 kilometers. The Konkan Railways has been covered in the Extreme Railways program by Chris Tarrant and considered as one of the most difficult railway projects to have been constructed in the world. E. Sridharan completed this project, after which he was involved in another new and wider project, which was the Delhi Metro project. You all know about Delhi Metro. E. Sridharan served as the managing director of Delhi Metro Rail Corporation. There are so many metro lines which connect to various places in Delhi. Every route is color-coded, having red, blue, pink metro lines. All these suggestions and ideas were initiated by Mr. Sridharan. Many government officials were involved and high-level meetings were held. The construction period of Delhi Metro was 10 years. Construction began in 1995 and in the year of 2005, the project was completed. All the management, analysis, coordination was mediated by Mr. Sridharan. We can say that this project was his brainchild. Delhi Metro is one of the largest metros and much bigger if we compare to the Kolkata Metro. He provided a lot of exposure to all of them while serving as the director manager of this project and completed his work very meticulously. Similarly, in Kerala, the Kochi Metro project was also managed and coordinated by E. Sridharan. Many other cities and places in India, such as Lucknow, Jaipur, Andhra Pradesh, and many other places wherever metro services are provided, have been coordinated and facilitated by E. Sridharan. With age not being on his side, he resigned from here, serving only as consultant to prior projects. He still is an expert and has a very wide range of knowledge in his field, having decades of experience in implementing the railway and metro projects. In the recent years, Mr. Sridharan, having retired from his professional career, decided to join a political party from his state, Kerala. He joined as a member of the BJP. The state elections were very competitive. Many parties opposed each other. But E. Sridharan stood with his chosen party. BJP lost that election. Congress and the AAP won. Mr. Sridharan was disappointed with the result as he was involved for nearly 1 year. He decided to resign from his political career as well. He did not want to work with political parties anymore. He finally decided to take rest, be at home and lead a peaceful life. This is the in-depth story of E. Sridharan's professional experience. He has been awarded numerous times with various national awards such as the Padma Bhushan and the Padma Shri. He also has received many other awards from the private and the government sectors. That is why Mr. E. Sridharan is such a well-known personality and nicknamed as the Metro Man.